It seems like we have Visit Salt Lake Tahoe Day. We have two QH1Hs parked in the background on the ramp. One has a chip problem on the main transmission. And then we have two AH1Hs parked here in the forefront. They came out to escort a Chinook that brought some transmission oil for the broken helicopter. So, and all that in one day. And then earlier, it was a llama parked here on the ramp, and I talked to the pilot. Llama, for you non-aviators, a llama is pretty much like an ancient old French helicopter, also known as an Alouette, made by Sud Aviat back in the 50s and 60s. And I guess the Cobras, with the two pilots each helicopter, getting ready to leave. And the two Hueys in the background, they are getting ready to stay overnight. They couldn't fix the transmission. And there's our baby. Yeah. Probably takes them 5 minutes to get everything running and autopilot test and GPS run up and down. That's what happens if you put too much electronics into a helicopter. We could probably get a flight request right now and still be off the ground before they are. Yeah, sorry for the poor video quality. Cell phone. What can you expect? Pretty cool helicopter though. I think the Marines are pretty smart with their choices of weapon systems. The QH-1H and the AH-1H have a 84% parts compatibility. So if a QH-1 breaks down, they can give them parts from a Cobra. Thank you. Tesla has a quick response. We're already 6.5 minutes into it. Alright. Things are starting to move. Marine Corps. This is kind of cool. And the Huey Cobra started in Vietnam. First Cobra flew in Vietnam. And now look at this high-tech beast. Twin engine, four blades, four tail rotor blades. Doesn't sound like a Huey anymore because of the four rotor blades. That's so pretty cool. Clint is walking his tour passengers back right over there. You alright? Hope you enjoyed the video.